Hello and welcome to everyone attending this course. My name is Jean-Claude Bergerman. I was the head of unit responsible for open access, open data and the science cloud in DGRTD. And together with my team, we developed what is known now as the European Open Science Cloud. So I will introduce you in a few minutes in what is the history of it, why did we do it, how will it look like, and what do we see as the future of it. So first of all, the history of the Open Science Cloud. Now, the idea of an open science cloud did not emerge as a standalone activity of a few people in Brussels not knowing what to do and thinking, well, what are we going to do the next few years? It is part of a broader set of policies we started developing in 2014, 15 and 16 to give a push towards what we then perceived as the irreversible trend to open science, which in the meantime is a trend. It's no longer irreversible, it is there. And as part of the package of that policy push towards open science, we came up as the second or the third priority. We came up with the priority of creating an environment for all the open data that will become available. Because the idea behind it was that all science will become data science, all funding, public funding in Europe, will require the results of that funding to be openly available. As a result of that, a massive tsunami of open data can be expected in the future to come. And that means that all these data need to be stored somewhere in a format that is accessible, reusable, interoperable. Because otherwise, why would you do it? If you do something to support open science, it has to be in a way that it makes science indeed open, which is not free, but open. So we formulated already in 2016 the priority: let's create this environment for managing the open data that will inevitably become more and more prevalent in European research. And that is what is called the European Open Science Cloud. So it was an idea of the scientific community, which we tried to develop into a policy. How did we do that? Well, we did not want to create a separate institution or a separate entity somewhere where all the data would be merged and then controlled by a few bureaucrats overlooking who get access to it or not, which is, by the way, completely stupid also, because the tsunami of data will be so huge that actually the science cloud should be readable and accessible not only by people but also by machines. But that's a side comment. So the idea was no centralized approach, a decentralized approach, federating the structures that already contribute to the Open Science Cloud, which are the repositories, the data infrastructures, the research infrastructures, the géants of this world, and creating the layer of access and of governance on top of it so that all these structures, all these federated entities, behave in a way that makes fair open data, findable, accessible, interoperable, usable data a reality. So if you take the metaphor of aviation, the science cloud is not regulating the planes, is not regulating the airport, is not regulating the pilots. What it does is setting up the rules of, once your plane is in the air, these are the conditions to, first of all, to become airborne, and secondly, in the air you have to behave to such and such rules. That's a science cloud. In 2000, so we did a lot of work there. We had to align all these institutions, these hundreds of repositories, all the ministries, 28 member states, but inevitably that was a complex thing, but we managed to get there, mainly because the idea is a good idea, mainly because it is an idea of the scientific community, not of a few, as I said, people in Brussels. So we managed to create a temporary structure for the science cloud and launch it at the end of 2018 in Vienna. We have put in place a governance board, an executive board, and a stakeholder forum. You can find all the details on our website, who is who and what is what. But the basic purpose of this is to kickstart the work on the science cloud, to come up with a proposal for a final structure to be launched in 2020, and to make sure, 2018, that we give the right signal to the rest of the world. The data that will emanate from the European research system, which is publicly funded, will be made available to the scientists of that system to make better science in a way which is compatible with European values and priorities. So in the essence, the cloud is a very simple idea with a very complex operational layout. But once the idea is shared by everyone, making the layout workable is relatively simple, and not the other way around. Thank you for your attention.